In order to draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams of the falling simply supported beam having distributive loading, we can start by first figuring out the support reactions. We can do that by developing the free body diagram first. Here at point A, we have a pin support. So we will have two support reactions, one in the vertical direction given by AY and one in the horizontal direction as AX. Next, I have a roller that have only one support reaction in the vertical direction given by CY. Next, we have a distributive loading of rectangular form, and we can figure out the area of the rectangle and convert it into a point load. Since we have 3 kilonewtons per meter and that is being applied to 6 meters, multiplying 3 with 6 give us the point load that is equals to 18 kilonewton, and it will act in the centroid of that rectangle that will be 3 meters from point A. Next, we have a triangular distributive loading, and we can convert this thing into a point load as well by figuring out the area of the triangle. Now, area of the triangle is half times base times altitude. Here, the base of the triangle is 3 meters, while the height is 6 shown here. However, we have already incorporated the rectangle, so the height will be 6 minus 3. So point load for that will be 4.5 kilonewtons. This point load will be acting at the centroid of the triangle, that is 1/3 from the higher end. Here the base is 3 meters, so that distance will be 1 meter from point C. Next, we can apply our equilibrium equation, starting with summation of forces along the horizontal direction equals to 0. In this case, we have only one force, that is AX, so it will be equals to 0. After that, we can apply summation of forces along the vertical direction and equate it equals to 0. Here, we have AY going in upward direction, so that's why we have a positive. Next, we have a point load of 18 kilonewtons and 4.5 kilonewtons in the downward direction. And finally, we have our CY going in the upward direction. Simplifying gives us our equation 1. Next, we can write our summation of moment equation at any point on the beam. Here, we have selected at point A, taking counterclockwise as positive. Since we are calculating the moment at point A, AY and AX won't create any moment, and we will start with our point load of 18 kilonewtons having a moment arm of 3 meters, making a clockwise moment. Next, we have a point load of 4.5 kilonewtons and the moment arm is 5. This also creates our clockwise moment. Finally, we have our support reaction CY in the upward direction with a moment arm of 6. This creates our counterclockwise moment. Simplifying, we can calculate the value of CY, which is 54 plus 22.5 divided by 6, coming 12.75 kilonewtons. Now, once we have the value of CY, we can plug it back in equation number 1 and solve for our support AY. So let's do that. Plugging the value of CY of 12.75 in equation 1 give us our value of AY as 9.75 kilonewtons. Now, once we have both the support reactions, we can go ahead and start drawing our shear force and bending moment diagram utilizing the methods of section. To do that, in this case, since we have a couple of discontinuities, we will have two sections to consider. Initially, we have to consider section from A to B, and after that, we have to consider section B and C. So let's go ahead and start solving for section AB. Now, since we are solving for section AB, we have to make a cut somewhere in between these two points. So let's go ahead and make a cut at a distance x from point A. Now, this value of x can be anywhere in between section A and B, so the value of x can vary from 0 all the way to 3. Next, we have to develop the free body diagram of the section that we have just cut. So, creating the free body diagram, I have my support at point A going in the upward direction of 9.75 kilonewton, and then we have our distributive load coming downward of 3 kilonewtons per meter. Now, since we have made a cut in the beam member, the internal forces of those members will become exposed. We have total of three internal loads. Normal force going along the axis of the beam. We have a shear force V acting vertically downward, and then we have our coupled moment M in the counterclockwise direction. Now, in this case, we are only interested with the shear force, and the moment and normal won't create any part here. So let's go ahead and write our equilibrium equation of summation of forces in the vertical direction equals to zero and solve for our shear force, that is V. Simplifying, we get the value of V as 9.75 minus 3x. Now, once we have the shear force, we have to plug in the value of x at the two extremes to identify how the diagram will look like. So plugging the value of x equals to 0 gives us our shear force of 9.75, whereas if we plug in the value of x equals to 3 in the equation above, we are getting a value of shear force of 0.75. Now, once we have these two extremes value at point A and at point B, let's go ahead and plot it on the diagram. So starting with at x equals to 0, that is our point A, we have our shear force of 9.75 kilonewtons. Where at point B, we have our value of 0.75 kilonewtons. Now, once we have the two extremes, we have to identify how the variation is happening from 9.75 to 0.75, and we have to go back to the equation that we have just developed. If you look, we have our linear equation, that 9.75 minus 3x, it is a linear equation. So the trend from 9.75 to 0.75 will be a straight line. Next, we can go ahead and write our summation of moment at the cut that we have just created and solve for the moment diagram. In this case, I have our point load of 9.75 having a moment arm of x, and this is creating our clockwise moment, whereas the point load of 3x is creating our counterclockwise moment with a moment arm of x over 2. Finally, we have our couple moment. We are just going to add it and equate this expression equals to 0. Simplifying, we get our moment equation as 9.75x minus 1.5x squared. Again, the step is the same. We have to plug in the value of x at the two extremes. So at x equals to 0, the value of m is coming also equals to 0. Whereas at x equals to 3, we are getting a moment of 15.75 kilonewtons meter. So let's go ahead and draw these on the diagram here as well. So starting from point A, the value of moment is 0, whereas at point B, the value is 15.75 kilonewtons meter. Next, we have to look at the profile, how the variation is happening from 0 to 15.75. So if you look at the equation, we have our quadratic equation. So we will have a quadratic profile going from A to point B. Now, once we have developed the shear force and bending moment diagram of our first section, let's move to the section BC, and we'll repeat the same process. We have to make a cut somewhere in between point B and C. Let's identify that distance as x measured from point A, and let's proceed with drawing our free body diagram of the section that we have just created. So let's go ahead and start with our support reaction of 9.7 kilonewton going in the upward direction. After that, we have our distributive loading. Now from point A to point B, I have just the rectangular distributive loading, and afterwards I have a combination of triangular and rectangular distributive loading. Now, since we have made a cut somewhere in between B and C, so the internal forces will become exposed. So we have our normal given as N, the shear force given as V, and then I have a couple moment given by M here. Now, since we have made a cut at a distance x, we are not sure about what will be the height of that triangle, and we need to identify that. However, since we know that for a complete triangle, the height is 6, so utilizing the similar triangles, we can identify what will be the height of the triangle in our section here. So first consider the bigger triangle. The base of that triangle is 3 meters and the height is also 3. Since we have to subtract the rectangular height that is shown here. Now this triangle that we have is similar to the smaller triangles that we have just made a cut, since the slope is identical. So let's compare these two triangles together. Here for the smaller one, the base value will be x minus 3 and the height is what we are looking for. So since we know that the ratios of the sides of the similar triangles are equal, we can compare these two ratios and solve for the unknown height here. So for the bigger triangle, we have the height as 3 as well as the base is 3. Comparing it with the height of the unknown triangle that we have to calculate and divide it with the base of x minus 3. In this case, the height will also be equal to x minus 3. Now, once we have this thing, we can now plug it back in our free body diagram and go ahead and start figuring out the point loads here. So to go ahead with it, let's consider the point load of first the triangular distributive loading. Since we have our value of 3 kilonewtons per meter and the distance is x here, so the point load will be 3x. Now this will be acting in the middle because of the centroid of rectangle lies in the middle. Next, we can go ahead and calculate the point load of the triangular distributive area by calculating the area of the triangle here. Since the area is half times base times altitude, and the base in this case is x minus 3, whereas the altitude of the triangle is also x minus 3. This gives us our point load of half times x minus 3 whole square. Now, once we have all the forces, we can go ahead and write our summation of forces in the vertical direction equals to 0 to figure out our shear force expression. So I have 9.75 going in the upward direction, then I have a point load of 3x going in the downward direction, and then we have our point load from the triangular distributive loading acting also in the downward direction. Finally, we have our shear force V acting in the downward direction as well. Simplifying gives us the expression of shear force that is coming 9.75 minus 3x minus half times x minus 3 whole square. Now, once we have this expression, we need to plug in the value of x at the two extremes of the section BC. So we have to plug in the value of x equals to 3. And if we do that, we are getting our shear force value of 0.75. Whereas at x equals to 6, we are getting a value of negative 12.75. Now in this case, since we are getting a negative value, there is a transition happening from positive shear force value to a negative shear force value at some point on the beam, and we have to identify that specific point that is known as the point of inflection. This point is extremely important because the moment at this specific point is the maximum. So let's go ahead and first solve for this point where the value of shear force is equals to 0. So plugging the value of V equals to 0 in the same expression, we go ahead and solve for x. In this case, simplifying, we get our value of x equals to 3.24 meters. So the point where the transition happening, or in other words, where we will have our maximum bending moment, will be at a distance of 3.24 meters from point A. Now, once we have that, let's go ahead and write our moment expression at the cut and solve for our bending moment diagram. So to start, we have our support reaction of 9.75 kilonewtons, and this will have a moment arm of x and creating our clockwise moment. Next, we have our 3x having a moment arm of x over 2, and this is going to create our counterclockwise moment. Finally, I have the point load from a triangular distributive loading given as half times x minus 3 times x minus 3. Next, for the moment arm, we know that the centroid of the triangle lies 1/3 from the higher side of the triangle, since the base is x minus 3. So 1/3 of that will be x minus 3 divided by 3. Finally, we have our couple moment of m going in the counterclockwise direction, that's why taken as positive. Simplifying, we get our moment expression of negative x cube over 6 plus 5.25x plus 4.5. Next, we have to plug in the values of x and solve for the actual value of moment to plot our diagram here. So to start with, let's consider the point of inflection at x equals to 3.24. We are getting our moment value of 15.8 kilonewton meter. Next, let's figure out our value at the extreme at x equals to 6. If we plug x equals to 6, we are getting our moment value of 0. Now, since we have identified the points, a couple of points, we have to draw the profile looking at the equation. Since we have our cubic equation, so we will have a cubic profile going upward to 15.8, as it is the highest point on our bending moment diagram because of the point of inflection, and after that coming downwards all the way to 0. This gives us our shear force and bending moment diagram.